Welcome back, dear viewers, and you're still watching The Breakfast Show. And in this segment of our program, we will talk about Eid al-Fitr, how can Muslims celebrate this special occasion. And now we are joined over the phone by Dr. Muhammad Saleh Shadid. He is a scholar at Al-Azhar. Good morning, sir, and happy Eid to you.
Hey, good morning, my sister, and I say happy feast upon all Muslim Ummah all over the world, and I say to all of them, Eid Mubarak. We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it a blessed feast. Ameen, Ya Rabbi.
Yes. Doctor, first, can you tell us how Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, celebrated the Eid?
In the beginning, we say, what about happiness in Islam?
Yes.
Prophet Muhammad, when he traveled or migrated from Mecca to Medina, he found the people of Medina or Yathrib making a celebration with many feasts. They used it to be happy during these days, during the days of Jahiliyyah or before Islam. He told them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us as Muslims two feasts. The first is Eid al-Fitr and second is Eid al-Adha. And joyness or happiness in Islam are mentioned is mentioned in many verses in the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَوْمَئِذٍ يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ بِنَصْرِ اللَّهِ. In that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make Muslims be happy during these days with victory. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in his hadith, وَلِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ فَرْحَتَانِ يَفْرَحُهُمَا. The Muslim will be happy during two days or situations or places. The first situation, when he finishes his fasting, he will be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him health to fast this month. And this day of happiness is the day of Eid, Eid al-Fitr. The second day when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy when he sees his good deeds during fasting. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in his hadith, وَلِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ يَفْرَحُمَا إِذَا أَفْطَرَ فَرِحَ بِفِطْرِهِ. He will be happy that he has completed fasting with the month of Ramadan. وَإِذَا لَقِيَ رَبَّهُ فَرِحَ بِصَوْمِهِ. He will see the reward of fasting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the holy hadith, al-hadith al-Qudisi, الصِّيَامُ لِي, fasting is for me. For fasting is a secret between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fasting is the only pillar of the pillars of Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it unlimited reward. Every prayer has limited reward. Except fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the hadith of the hadith, إِلَّا الصَّوْمَ, except fasting, فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجِزِي بِهِ. This is reward according to the sincerity of the fasting. Yes. And this is happiness in Islam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he prayed Salat al-Eid or fasting or the feast prayer back to his house, and he has found two young girls singing songs, and he sat or laid down and listened to them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This means that happiness in Islam is mentioned in many verses in the Quran and also in the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
So, doctor, yes, please.
And we are saying that this day is a day of happiness, the day of visiting your relatives, helping the poor and the needy, and it is not a day of visiting graves. No, this is, the scholar said it is wrong, to visit graves during the day of feast. Therefore, this is the day of happiness. Don't mix between happiness and sadness. This is the day as Prophet Muhammad has a Yawm Iduna. So Prophet Muhammad ordered the Muslims, men, women, young girls, young boys, all of them, to go out from their houses, from their flats, and attend the prayer of Eid, for this is the day of happiness. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Yes.
Of the takbir ritual.
A question again?
What is the significance and the meaning behind the takbir rituals?
Takbir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned after fasting, in the beginning, or he began fasting by saying, Ya ayyuha al-lazina, is addressing or speaking to the believers, not Muslims. Why believers? What is the difference between them? The believer believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Iman, this is according to what is in heart. But as Muslim, any person can bring a certification or paper or ID that he is a Muslim. So Allah addressing the Muslims to fast, and after fasting, he will accept their dua. After fasting, he said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. This is after making prayer, after making fasting. And after fasting, Allah accepts your dua. And when we finish dua and we finish qiyam and so on, Allah said, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهِ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. This is to say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allah is greater than my work, my life, my wife, everything. Allah is greater than of anything. So, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. This is the day of feast. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ.
Yes.
This is obligatory. All Muslims all over the world, they say Allah, Allahu Akbar is the only one that He is gathering us in His house, gathering us on purity. For every Muslim has to go to the mosque in purity, purity of heart, purity of body, and so on, purification. So, وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. For He has guided us, and you say Allahu Akbar, for He has guided us to Islam. Guided us to know the truth, and we didn't change anything in Islam. We didn't change any pillar of the pillars of Islam. We didn't change the prayer. We didn't change fasting or paying zakah or hajj. For we are following the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he said, "Khudhu anni manasikakum, pray as you see me pray." This is walitukabbiru Allah ala ma hadakum, for He has guided us to fast the month of Ramadan and to celebrate the feast of Eid al-Fitr.
So, Doctor, to what extent does Islam urge compassion, solidarity among members of the society, especially during Eid?
After every prayer, you may see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made additional or voluntary ibadah or worship. After the obligatory prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a supererogatory prayer, Salat al-Sunnah. Why? For the person, if he is praying his prayer and forget anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the supererogatory prayer, Salat al-Sunnah, to complete the wrong, the mistake that he had made. And after fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made charity. This charity to complete the wrong that has made during fasting, for to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in complete fasting. So, Zakat al-Fitr is obligatory upon every Muslim person, man, woman, young, old, free, slave, all of them. So, Zakat al-Fitr is sa'am min tamri, sa'am min sha'irin, and we are giving this charity to the poor, to the needy, before you go to fast the feast, before you go out to pray, Salat al-Eid, the feast prayer. You have to give this charity to your brother, to your sister, the needy, the poor, to be happy as you be happy. This is solidarity. And this is, this Zakat al-Fitr is more charity. And we have other higher charity. This is called as Zakat. General Zakat, this is obligatory upon the rich only. But Zakat al-Fitr upon every person that he has food in his house. Imagine my sister and all listeners, those who are listening to us now or watch us, that million Muslims all over the world are giving charity to the poor, to the needy. This is a case of solidarity, cooperation between the members of society in every country.
So, sir, what if a person forgets to pay Zakat al-Fitr? Is his fasting accepted?
So this is, I say, this is what is obligatory is fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha allatheena amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, all your belief, fasting is obligatory upon you. He didn't mention Zakat al-Fitr, but Zakat al-Fitr, this is super obligatory upon the person to complete the mistakes that the person made during the fasting.
So, also, sir, can you tell us about fasting, the 6 days of Shawwal, voluntary fasting, the importance of these 6 days?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It is Sunnah upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to fast other days other than Ramadan. Ramadan, this is the second pillar of the pillars of Islam. Shahada, Iqamat Salah, Itai Zakah, Sawm Ramadan, this is one of the pillars of the pillars of Islam. So, after fasting the month of Ramadan, there are days or special days Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast these days as the 6 days of Shawwal, as he said in his hadith, من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan and fasted other 6 days or followed it by fasting 6 days of Shawwal as if he has fasting the whole year.
Yes, Doctor. Also, Doctor Shadid, let's also talk about the importance of maintaining the spirit of Ramadan throughout the year. How can we preserve this spirit?
So, leave the spirit of the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is a camp to train or for training Muslims to control their speaking. As Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فإذا كان صوم يوم أحدكم. If one of you is fasting, فلا يرفث ولا يصحب, don't say wrong, don't speak bad, or hoflish, or something like this. فإن كان صومه أحدهم فلا يرفث. فإن سابه أحد, if someone saying something wrong to me, I not say the same to him, but I speak to good or not speak. فليأكل خيرا أو ليصمت or not to speak. The month of Ramadan has made control for us. If someone is smoking, we ask during the other days, in the month of Ramadan, he stops. So the month of Ramadan is a camp for training the Muslims to control their mouth, to control in their heart, their feelings, and so on. So the person has to take lessons from this month. Number one, he used it to fast the month of Ramadan, so he can fast the Monday and the other days. He used it to pray at night, so after Ramadan, he can pray at night. This is a camp of training for Muslims. He used to recite the Quran during the month of Ramadan. He has to leave with this spirit after the month of Ramadan. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said in his hadith, الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. So fasting and the Quran will intercede for the person in the day of judgment. The Quran will speak. Or he will say, oh my Lord, I had prevented him sleeping at night, for he is reciting Quran. Fasting will say, oh my Lord, let me intercede for this person, for this man, for this woman, for they used to fast during the day. They have prevented themselves from eating and drinking for the sake of you. So let me intercede for this person. And the Prophet said, their intercession will be accepted, subhanAllah. And either Prophet Muhammad said in his hadith, الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. So the Quran mentioned after fasting, for fasting and fasting, and the Quran, both of them in the month of Ramadan. Allah has made fasting in the month of Ramadan obligatory, and either laid down the Quran during the month of Ramadan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of Ramadan, is the Lord of the whole year, not only for the Lord of Ramadan, but we are worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan and after Ramadan. I be good in Ramadan and after Ramadan. Give charity during Ramadan and after Ramadan. I used to pray at night during Ramadan and after Ramadan. This is the Muslim for all of us not know the time of this. So the person may die in a case of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prepare his intention. So after every ibadah, the person has to go to other ibadah worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yes, I'd like to thank you, Mr. Dr. Muhammad Shadid Al-Azhar, a scholar. Thank you for being with us, Doctor, and dear viewers.